What's up, gamers? It's your boy ImperiousEagle36 back at it again with another Bed Wars video, and let's get right into it. Now, how was that for an intro, my guys? So I have quite a lot of things I want to talk about this episode, this video. So without further ado, shall we get into it? According to YouTube statistics, no one watches my videos. Oh, okay, never mind then. Let's go play it then. Block game make happen. Alright, what's up, gamers? This is Post Processing Imperius here. Just to let you know, this video is a tiny bit framey because OBS was acting strange, so I'd still appreciate it if you watched it a tiny bit. Thanks. And if I sound a little bit tired, it's because I've recorded this video twice before already, but one of them was a bad recording, and the other one, the file got corrupted, so that's wonderful. Yeah, thanks for watching, leave a like, subscribe, and we are about to start in 3, 2, 1! Alright, gamers, so I'm doing kind of a different video today. I just didn't have time to record, like, voiceovers while I was playing, so I just decided to do this sort of thing instead of play the voiceover while watching me play. So, Aqua's here, and then, boom, I hit him, and he falls off as well. That's pretty epic. So, today, I had quite a few things I want to talk about. The first one being that intro, that very epic intro, I know. So, I created it myself, and it was pretty good. So I got into like the intro making sort of thing, I don't know, this past weekend, like the weekend of the 16th or whatever, I don't know. But I was just scrolling through YouTube and I saw some cool profile pictures, and you know, like with the like the shaders and stuff and the After Effects, and it was pretty epic. So I decided I should try making it because kind of a smart guy, not to toot my own horn or anything. Aqua was eliminated. Aqua DC'd, so I was able to get the bed here. Yeah, so I just decided, let me try making something. So I got Cinema 4D, and I started making stuff. And at first, it was okay. Here's one of my here's the first one that I made. It's not the greatest, right? There's not really any After Effects. It's just a bit plain. And then here's the second one that I made. It's a lot better. I actually have it as my background. I'm pretty proud of it, to be honest. And yeah, I just think that it was a very fun experience, and it was pretty straightforward. There's quite a lot of videos on it, actually. Like, a surprising amount. So, yeah, I was doing that, and then so after I was watching, like, how to do all this stuff, a lot of people were making intros, and so I was just like, I should try making that intro as well. Not necessarily intros, but also animations with... But also animations, and I thought they were pretty cool, and I was like, I should try that. They looked pretty hard at first, but then once I saw like how to do it, it was actually pretty easy. It was actually pretty straightforward, and it was kind of like using the replay mod, like using the keyframes and stuff. I don't know, it was pretty simple, and I made the intro. So at first I had a lot of trouble with the run cycle. Like at first you see, if you go back to the intro, you see the guy, my character running. And I had quite a lot of trouble with that actually. And then I searched a few videos and it was pretty straightforward as well. Yeah, just once you get the hang of it, it's not that hard. And so after that, I made the thing, and I think it took me, I don't know, if I was to like put all the time together, maybe like 12 hours of work, I would say. Yeah, that seems reasonable. 12 hours of work, and but yeah, I got distracted quite a lot of times, and yeah, I got distracted quite a lot of times, and but it was just fun. Here I'm invis, and boom, shears, and I die, I think, yeah, because I'm bad. But yeah, overall it was a cool experience, and I just had the image in my head that I wanted to do the intro and like how it should be, and I think it turned out pretty good. And then I put some music to it, and I searched up like the intro templates. And I searched up like intro templates, and like I stitched it together. That's why you see the Imperius Eagle with the epic music. Obviously, this guy tries to block track me here. I don't know what his plan was. I break a block here, that's kind of stupid. And so at first, I was like thinking I should like make I should use the map Siege, because I don't know, I thought it would look cool. That's how I like pictured it in my head, but I couldn't find any map downloads for Siege, so I decided to use Lighthouse instead. I think it worked okay. I don't think it gave off the same effect that I was looking for, but you gotta do what you gotta do. That hit didn't register right there, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So yeah, and on the topic of the intro, you guys saw my new skin, and I think it's pretty cool. So basically what I did was, yeah, so basically what I did was I just like tried to make a skin that kind of looked like me, but and I think it turned out pretty well. It sort of resembles me, and it's got the gamer guy look or whatever. I tried to kind of match it with the old skin as well, with like the sweatshirt and the color scheme sort of thing. I kind of got it like with the blue, black, white. I think it turned out pretty good. The main reason why I did it was like to for editing purposes for the video rendering. Yeah, the layers of the old skin, how it was pixelated and stuff, didn't really work well, because then it would like fold over the wrong part, or another part would like go the wrong direction. So yeah, I kind of had to make a new skin. But that was that. Hold on, I need to talk about more stuff. I forget what I need to talk about. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. So if you just so I am now using Lunar Client. Yes. Epic, I know. Very interesting. I mainly switched because I thought it would give higher FPS. I think it actually does. But it also has a bunch of features like the mods and stuff, which is also another main reason why I got it. My friend told me that I should get a client because of all the mods that it has, and it has been pretty useful. I mean, it's got the keystrokes mod, status effect mod, the armor HUD mod, the auto sprint, auto GG, FPS, ping, combos. It's got all that good stuff, you know? All the good stuff. So yeah, I've been using that recently. And at first I thought there was no perspective mod, But there actually was. It's funny because Sammy Green just made a video about it, like, I don't know, like a week ago. And I was like, hey, I know that because I use Perspective Mod and it wasn't there. And I tried using it and it just, I didn't see any options for it. But the other day, like a few days after I got Lunar, I happened to accidentally click Alt and started using the Perspective Mod. And I was like, wait, what? And so I went into settings, and it said that Perspective Mod was bound to left menu, which is apparently Alt, I guess. I don't know. But, yeah, so I was able to use Perspective Mod, which I was pretty happy about. And, yeah, the CPS counter on the keystroke mod for some reason looks a tiny bit different, but it's not really that noticeable. But yeah, on the topic of the CPS, I managed to find a way to drag click. So the other day I was just playing around on PvP land, and people were talking about drag clicking in chat, and so I was like, I wonder if I could drag click. So I tried on this mouse, obviously it didn't work. It's like a cheap mouse, but it's like good quality at the same time. So it wasn't able to drag click, and I was thinking about buying a more expensive mouse for drag clicking, but I didn't really want to buy one, you know, just not really waste the money. So I just went around looking for a mouse that would work, 'cause you know, everyone just has random mice lying around in their house, and so I found one, and it's like a Logitech MUAE 96 or something. Yes, I remember the model. And somehow I was able to drag click. And it drag clicked pretty well. Like I was able to, for on long drags, I was able to get almost 30 CPS, and short drags of like 14, 15 around there. It was pretty fun. I was able to do moonwalks, breezily. I couldn't nail the God Bridge because I wasn't consistent in double clicking, but I was able to breezily pretty well. I could get like a good 20 blocks, I would think, without fail on the first day of me actually trying. So yeah, that was pretty epic. And yeah. So that's what's been happening in my life. Oh yeah, and so over Christmas, I was just playing around, and I came across this YouTuber who was scroll clicking, using the scroll wheel to click. Like each scroll would be a click, and you were able to get like 50 CPS with it. And he was doing it with the Logitech G502, meaning that he could use like an air compressor and unlock the scroll wheel and then just spin it up to like, I don't know, like 10,000 RPM. But yeah, he was getting like 40,000 CPS. So I tried it out. I downloaded a client for it, not through Minecraft, just like a regular mouse modifying client, and it worked. And it worked like surprisingly well. So I tried God Bridging with it, and that didn't turn out real great because I kind of got banned from mcplayhd.net. And I was so yeah, I can pull up the transcript here. And yeah, so I had to get a ban appeal, and I was released within 2 days, so that was good. So I was able to continue with my bridging career, and I didn't want to get in trouble again, so I stopped scroll clicking. But yeah, I think I got on mcplayhd.net. If you've gone there before, then you'll know that they take like recordings of your times, and I think I got like 16, but that's pretty bad. But yeah, that's basically all I have for today. Hope you guys like this video. This is sort of a different video. And like and subscribe if you want. Oh yeah, OBS cuts out here, so I'm gonna end the video here. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. Tell me in the comments if you like that these types of videos, and goodbye.